following statement is being issued at this moment in Washington and Hanoi. At 12:30 Paris time today, January 23, 1973.
Ain't it just like the night to play tricks when you're trying to be so quiet?
That's when she knew it was over for good.
This was the first opportunity I had to work with Todd Haynes, who is an amazing film director. And it was the unusual thing was that he's also an editor. He knows how to edit and had been doing it for many years and was pretty good at it. And he had a slightly different take on the dailies watching process. Again, the chaos of production prevented him from watching dailies too much during the shoot. I saw him during the shoot a few times, but not regularly. I was building my assembly while he was shooting, and then we went off to edit the film together. And he spent the first 10 weeks of the post-production process at home, watching the dailies from beginning to end by himself, and taking the most meticulous notes I had ever seen in my life. An elaborate book of graph paper with every line in a scene and every take in a scene and all kinds of different notations, check marked.
Ladies and gentlemen, I wish to thank each and every one of you. You made it marvelous for me. Cheers to all of you.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Louise. Louise!
And I would get those notes every morning. His assistant would stop at his house, get those notes, drop them off to me. I would look at what he had appreciated in the dailies and start to incorporate those choices into the assembly that I was working on. But he also did want to continue doing some cutting. And so my assistant and I would come in the morning and I would cut all day. Todd would come in the late afternoon and look at what I had gotten up to. And then we would work together for a few hours. And then my assistant would go off for the day, and he would take over her Avid, and we would both cut for a couple hours. I would call it a night, and he had a habit of working through the night. And I would come in the next morning and see what kind of progress he had made and what kind of mess he had made. But he was very gracious about it, but it was great. There was a certain amount of mess, but there was a certain amount of really great stuff. And he was very, very gracious about the whole thing. He always would come in the following day, look at what I had gotten up to, and then ask what I had thought of what he had left behind, and what I thought worked, and what I thought didn't work, and we would talk about that, and we would sort of bring, and I would bring the two together. And it was terrific. It was a great experience for me.